he came into this world by being born as a baby that was born in the grave. He came here to fulfill the purpose and the plan of God. He came here to bless you, to save you. It's true that as we are celebrating the birth of Jesus, of course he was not born on December the 25th, but because we're going to honor the birth of Jesus Christ, because we need to understand that, take the time to understand the beauty of the birth of Jesus Christ and why God sent him into this world. And how this all came about was a miracle. For Mary, that had an angel Gabriel came and actually appeared before her, declaring that she was highly favored of the Lord, letting her know that the Lord is with you and blessed are you among women. Of course, when you stop and think about that, why would this event be such a significant issue? How is it possible that this actually took place? I'm sure just as much as Mary was kind of troubled in this saying, we can also kind of wonder ourselves how much of this, what kind of manner of salutation can this be? And just like God is telling us even today, like he told Mary, he doesn't want us to be living in fear or worry. In fact, through the birth of Jesus Christ, God is introducing to us the favor of God. Amen. And if you want to find favor with God, is to understand, to receive the message that God gave. The only difference is that Mary conceived in her womb and brought forth a son called his name Jesus. The only difference that we're conceiving is conceiving in our hearts to give birth to his life within us, the same spiritual birth that took place in the womb of Mary that was in the life of Jesus Christ. We just want you to understand, it's a miracle. This birth is a miracle that took place in the womb of Mary. But it's also a miracle for you when you receive Christ as your Savior. And just like Mary received this message from Gabriel, the angel Gabriel, and she simply believed what the message was, that how the Holy Spirit was going to overshadow her. Therefore, the holy thing that shall be born in her shall be called the Son of God. And it's the same manner how God is bringing this message to us about the birth of Jesus Christ. That for this to take place in your life, the Holy Spirit must overshadow you and give birth of his life within us. Hallelujah. And it's just as much as a miracle for Christ to come alive in you as it was in the Jesus being born in the womb of Mary. And as a result of her simplicity of humbling herself and accepting a message from the angel, she said, "Be it unto me according to thy word." And exactly the same thing, whether you're young, whether you're old, coming to you today to take the time to open your heart to the Holy Spirit, welcoming the birth of the life of Christ to come into your heart, to save you, to forgive you, to heal you, to bring peace to your heart, bring love and compassion. And so that love that God gives to us will give you the love for your loved ones, to your children, to your families, to the wives and the husbands from all walks of life, and bringing a birth of love within us through Jesus Christ, so that we can all gather together in worship God. Take this time to be a remembrance of remembering the birth of Jesus Christ that will now come alive within our hearts because we're opening our hearts to Jesus. Hallelujah. We are going to receive this grace from the Lord. And so let us sing this awesome song. Amen. And let's worship God. Thank you. It's December the 24th today, and many of you are gathering together, whether today or tomorrow, coming together and feasting, singing, having beautiful time together. Even some of you are opening your gifts and everything else. And since I'm not able to be there with you, I am coming to you in this way. I want to just share with you that how much I appreciate you and how much I love you and how much I want God to bless you this time of season. I want to encourage you to bring comfort to your heart, and if there's any areas in your heart you feel that you're lacking comfort and peace in your life, I just want you to know that the one I know wants to give a gift to you this very day. It comes from the throne of God. It comes from our Lord and Savior, who was born 2,000 years ago, who wants to bless you with eternal life, everlasting life, to bring peace, to bring healing to your troubled heart, to bring peace to those who are discouraged, or those who feel depressed, or those who need to be uplifted, and you that are rejoicing and are happy and enjoying your time together. The gift that God wants to give you today is the gift of love. Give a gift for the purpose for this time for your lives. To give you a gift that you need in your heart. You know, to fill that void in your heart, to fill that emptiness, or fill anything that you're lacking in your life. This can only come from Jesus. And as you open up your heart, let the Holy Spirit come and meet with you this very hour. Let Him overshadow you with the Holy Spirit and fill you and baptize you in His presence of His holiness, and bring peace and love to your life. So He can raise you up, that He can raise you up to get high on the mountain, to raise you up that you can walk through the stormy seas of this life, and to cause you to become strong when you're yielding your life to the living God. And I just want to tell you, Merry Christmas, Happy New Year. Let this year be the greatest time of your life with the Lord and His love and His mercy. If you've never given your life to Him, today is the day that God wants to bless you. I'm going to sing one more song, and I'm sharing my love with you all. Thank you. December the 24th into your home. Oh, that God will fill you with peace and comfort. And give birth to this life for Jesus Christ. That God will heal your brokenness on the inside. Fill that emptiness and that void. Bring us together with Jesus Christ. To unite together in His love and His mercy. So He can wash away your burdens and your cares of this life. And we can lay them down at His feet as we wait upon our Lord. As we wait quietly and wait till He comes and reveals His mercy. Especially this very day in your heart. And since I can't be there with you, I pray that my presence, and also the presence of the Lord, will be there with you. And I just want to tell you, I just love you all. May God bless you. Have an awesome day in Jesus.